Hey guys, welcome back to My Mail Tech. Today we're going to install the software on the last Raspberry Pi build that we did. Like I said before, we're going to use something called BerryBoot. Essentially, this is going to boot off of your micro SD, and that'll start up your Pi. But then everything else is going to run off of our SSD once it's up and booted. So we're going to go through that process now. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our micro SD. All right, so we got our SD card in. It's here, it's in G. Go to properties. You're gonna see it's EXFAT. I had to do a little bit of research, and EXFAT is the modern version of FAT32. So we're good there on that card. All right, so one of the next things we're gonna do here is we're gonna go to our website with BerryBoot. So I have my my micro SD card's in there. So I'm gonna come here, download BerryBoot for Raspberry Pi, blah, blah, blah. So we'll go ahead and download this. Your download will start shortly. Blah, blah, there it goes. You can see it down here in the corner. Look at that. So we're gonna want to, this will be all of BerryBoot. So we're gonna wanna extract all. I'm actually just going to extract it all straight to here, just straight to the SD. Look, we got all kinds of BerryBoot goodness there on the SD card, you know, all the stuff we need. We'll go ahead and we will eject that, because we're done with that now. So BerryBoot comes with a bunch of OSs on it already, and you know, which is cool. You can use those. We'll look at those here in a minute, but I want to put a different OS on that. So what you need is, you know, some type of USB thumb drive, something like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and put one of those into my PC now. And we're gonna go to this page here. And again, I'm gonna put links to these in the description. So what this page is this is highly compressed versions of different operating systems that are, you know, BerryBoot friendly. And, you know, that's gonna be important because it's a different file system that BerryBoot uses. All right, so what I want to do is I want to download Twister OS. I'll click on that. It's going to start the download. It's going to ask you where you'd like to install it. We'll plop it on the desktop. Let it do its thing. We need to extract the file. Downloads, Twister. We want to extract. What do we want to extract it to? We're going to go to USB, put it in Twister OS. So now that we have that extracted, we're going to go ahead and go here, and you can see we have Twister OS here. Also have my ROMs and everything in here and some other things. But anyways, we'll go ahead and eject that. And we're going to get ready to fire up our Raspberry Pi. I've inserted the SD card into the Pi. After you boot up, you're gonna have this screen here. You're gonna see that you have, just some options up there. You have to forgive me, I'm trying to get used to this mouse I just put up here. But anyways, you're gonna have these, a couple options. We'll go ahead and we will set up the Wi-Fi. So after your internet's hooked up, or you could skip it if you wanted, I'm just going to select, you want to select the destination drive. Destination drive is going to be, this looks like this is our SSD here. So I'm going to select that because, you know, you need the SD card in here to boot, but everything's going to run off the SSD. It's going to be, you know, really fast. So we're going to go ahead and format that. It'll create partitions. It'll do all its happy jive. Give it a second there. So this will come up next. Now you can download or install any of these you want. You know, here's just some of the OSs that it comes with. Boot, you know, so if one of these is something you want, you would just select one and, you know, go from there. But we have a custom OS that we're going to put in that's not on this list. What we're going to do next is we're going to hit cancel here. I'm going to say the installation is not complete. Press to reboot. We'll go ahead and do that. All right, so we're going to be at this screen here, and we're going to long press with left here, and it's going to say copy OS from USB stick. We're going to select that. And you can see I got a whole bunch of stuff here, but we want Twister OS. Let's go ahead and select that. And we're going to open. It's going to copy the files. Let's give that a couple minutes. Okay, so here we are now. Everything is loaded up. We're going to select Twister OS. Set it as default. Then after that, we're going to choose exit. It should reboot. There we go. Lovely, lovely, lovely. The moment of truth. Oh, there we go. So it's going to give you a countdown. If you have multiple OSs on this, you know, this is your chance to choose, or you can just click boot and it'll boot it up. Anyways, so here's Twister OS. I'm going to have to try to hurry this up. The baby's waking up in the next room. So what you're going to see here is it'll have like a little walkthrough that you can go through. It'll talk about, you know, Pi configuration and, you know, update your system, you know, just all kinds of stuff. But some of this stuff I'm not really familiar with, but it's got like a good interface here. It'll have RetroPie. That's going to be kind of cool for me. I have a lot of ROMs, as we saw earlier. You know, you got some stuff here. It talks about, it's got all your usage, your, you know, just there's a lot to play with here. So, you know, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. You know, give it a thumbs up if you do. And we'll just kind of go from there. And this is Lewis from Mindmeld Tech. And I hope you enjoyed this. Hope you found it useful. If you have any questions, you know, let me know.